Having been approached by the powers that be behind the production of this fine epistle of spiritual understanding, to put pen to paper by way of an introduction, a commendation. Hello there, my name is Watt Nicol, and some years ago I wrote a show under the banner of Scotch, which was pretty much a look at Scottish history through the bottom of a whiskey bottle, because the whiskey is pretty much associated, it's almost a recording of the history of this land, Scotland. You take the Shackleton here, according to the label, 1907, over 100 years old. My God, that could tell you a few tales, eh? And if I just have a wee dram, I'd probably end up telling you a few tales as well. Well, none of them I would regret, but anyway, we'll come back to that. It's not just about Scottish whisky. This DVD is about whisky from all over the world. Naturally, as a Scot, I tend to favour the likes of the Aberfeldy. I mean, what a name alone, the Aberfeldy, single Highland malt. You just talk about that, you can hear the pibroch and you can smell the heather and see them running about in their kilts there. That's just pure history, that. When we look over here, here is a wee favourite of mine. Big Pete. Those of you who know anything about Big Pete would maybe recognise there is a sort of cultural association between myself and this fella. Oh, that's got character. That's what I would say about that. And here we have, here. I'll just have a look at this. Some would say Bruichladdy, others would say Bruichladdy, and I'll tell you, once you've had one or two of them, you don't give a damn how they say it, other than let's have another one. Because that's the effect whiskey has. It's not just a drink, it's not just something with an alcoholic content. Each and every one has character. They all have their own very special character. Edradour. Oh, look at that. Caledonia Edradour. Aged 12 years, but they're 12 magic years. That's gone from cunning chemist to cask and from cask to bottle and comes. And what you want to do really is close your eyes when you have a wee dram or something like this and think about how it earned that name. Have a wee look up through CS Whiskey and see an expert, hear what they have to say about each and every one of these. Irish whiskey, we've had all sorts of things. One of my favourite stories when I was doing the research for Scotch was I came up with a story that the Japanese tried to come up with their own whiskey and it looked good and it smelled braw and all the rest of it. They made one mistake because when they brought it out, on the label, they had put made from the best Scottish grapes. We had them there. You see, these people from all over the world, they make, there's no such a thing as a bad whiskey, you understand? There's no such a thing. You go into CS Whiskey and you will find. It's a whole cultural learning process. You will be welcome anywhere in the world if you can talk about whiskey, because the rest of the world wants to know the secret. And you know something? Some people say it's our water, some people say it's our peat, some people say it's our grain. But no matter where they come from, the whiskies, they all bow, they all raise their hat to the Scottish whisky. Because you know what we had that none of them can reproduce? The cunning chemists. You get into CS Whisky and I'll tell you something. You will never regret what that stuff will teach you and what that stuff will make you capable of doing. Here's to you. Enjoy your dram. Oh, 100 years old.